Okay. So, it looks like this one we're going to be looking at how to, affect a list from another function. So, let's see, first, target gets destroyed. Yes. Alright. So basically when the target gets destroyed, it needs to look for itself on the list and destroy it. Hey, Firedo, how's it going? And this is where the list is actually at. I think we actually did that last time. We're now just trying to confirm. Remaining on the list can be found if I tell it to spit out the details of what's on the list, because I can't look at a static list in the inspector. I actually was hanging out with the maker of Black Ice in his channel yesterday while I was developing, and I asked him about that. How can I look at an inspector or a He thought about it for a moment. No, I don't know. I stumped on that one. I wasn't asking as a riddle, though. I actually would love to know, but I don't think there's an easy way short of creating an extension of some, or not an extension, creating a a UI list or something that's gonna just keep iterating over it or whatever. All right. So I have a bookmark that has information on lists that was linked to me in a previous episode. So I'm going to reference that right now. Actually, just give me the list.count. Okay. No problems, okay. Oh, I should probably have that dual analog handy. Oops. Cool. Alright, let's add a few more targets to the scene then. I'll do that in level manager here. Yes, yes, I love Bruce Lee quotes, and this one in particular is pretty good, but this is a chiptune station, not a low-res quote station. I think this track is probably a bit too modern. Yeah, it is. Ugh, okay, I'm going to have to request some music then to cut the rate of music that is modern but is written using some amount of chiptunes rather than stuff that is written in the classic sense of chiptunes. So give me just a moment. I'm just going to queue up a few tracks. Then I might adjust the air conditioner because it's getting kind of hot here. That'll be good for a little bit. All right. Oh yeah, so wave and unit. So let's do 2. Okay. So let's run this. So that looks like it's working just fine. All right. I'll space these out. just to give it a little more variation. There we go. Okay. I'm just looking over some list-related things right now. Probably actually more what I need is how to work with some strings and stuff. Okay. Cool. Okay, so they can record to the list properly. And that means... these are just here for testing. Those can be getting moved. I'll leave them though. Display for verification. So how's everybody doing today? Who's all in here anyway? Hey, Ritzadet, I haven't heard you say anything in a while. Are you still around, or are you just kind of logged in all the time? I understand it's kind of odd timing for you. Xbox ROM Hunt, Wick, Tennis, Shadow Scout, Senor Blanco, Milo 1887. Well, hello, everybody. Appreciate y'all hanging out. Oops. So right now I'm just looking at stuff related to strings. Gotcha. Answer I'm looking for might be here. Serialized list. Kind of a nutty way to do it. I don't know nothing about no XML. The only thing I know about XML is that it isn't HTML. Hmm. No, I take it back. I don't think serialized is what I'm looking for. That might be a part of it, but that's not. I think I need to be looking more into Unity string stuff. P. Gibson, thank you very much. I've never. It's something that's possible, but I don't know if that's necessarily the right solution here. P. Gibson 8. Yeah, I don't know if Bob Ross been referred, his hair is referred to as a fro, or if he just had happy, poofy hair or whatever. But yeah, I think it's more of that kind of a poof that I'm going for at this point. Actually sending me, this is where I'm looking now. But I don't use XML. I don't know XML. I don't know how to work with XML. And I don't know that XML is going to make this any easier. All I need is code that can look through my list for the wave and the unit number and determine if the wave has ended or not. That's all I really need. I'm sure somebody who's really sharp with C# would just be able to come up with something in like 10 minutes. Yeah, it's just I have the list going that says what all is in the scene, what targets, in terms of what wave and what unit number they are. But I don't know that it's going to be any easier using XML than simply working within what's already there. Thank you. It's a good question. You know, the target actually doesn't have a an identifier for the wave and the unit number on it. Maybe that would be a thing to do, is search through the list and look at the properties of the transform rather than the name of the transform. Would that be easier? Because the target itself, it's the base color, whether it's blue or red, the score, and then all of the movement related stuff on the target movement script. Current pattern, velocity spiral. So I suppose I could add wave and a unit as actual variables on it. But one way or another, I still have to iterate through the list and see if those things exist or not. Oh yeah, that's in level manager here. This right down here. New target.gameobject.transform.name. It takes in the indicator for what wave and what unit number it is, and assigns that as the name for the object. So I could assign it there if I was going to do the unit and wave declarations. Yeah, I should be able to. Whoops, I'm looking at... No, it's target script. Target.name. No, I'm actually getting the, I mean, it... could. I suppose I am technically referencing the name because that's what it sees on the list. Here, let me show you in-game when I, whoops. So when I destroy something, it lists off the wave number and the unit number, and that is the actual name of the object. And here, when I create the scene again, you can see down here. Oh, thank you for the follow, Brief Zerd. Thank you. Interesting name. But yeah, you can see unit 1, 2, and 3 there. I could access the name. Yeah. I mean, I think it'd be the same if I just do this. Or it'll on paper look the same, I bet. Yeah. Kill those. Yeah, exact same thing. Instead of the saying transform, it just says the actual name. So, you know, plus or minus the same sort of thing. I suppose that is an important detail, though, because now it's actually giving it a string and not a transform. Yeah, Tannis, that's pretty much the goal. That's kind of what I was building towards. Yeah, I probably could. Something like this. Hmm. Yeah, I don't know either. Split, really? I don't know why you've got a parsing error. Everything lines up. No, that has to line up to that. There's no parsing errors here. Do I just need a one of those? Probably. So that runs without error. But there's some problem with this part. Doesn't look like this is really working for me here. Thank you. Guess and check, I'm fine with that. Collapse needs to be off, that would probably help. Yeah, Fluffy, how you doing? They have a split function, C sharp. Okay. I mean, I figured they would. I think it was something I saw in the Bergzerg arcade tutorial. I just don't recall. I could flip through my notes and maybe try to find it. Just for now, I'll just... Cool deal, cool deal. What were you watching? Anything particularly entertaining? Should be fine. Oh. Rex. What were they doing? Playing Magic? Do you find it more entertaining to watch people play Magic or watch people play Hearthstone? Thank you. So, let's see. Every time the target's destroyed. So, press play, destroy a target. And let's see what we get. Target wave 001, 001, 001, 002. Gotcha. Oh, neat. So yeah, whenever a target is destroyed, this basically iterates through the entire target list. Which is what it's supposed to do. Magic does have over a decade of complexity going into it, but I don't know. I'd rather see, honestly, I would rather see limited rule sets, like only the first 5 years, only those sets of cards. Because there were some really brutal goblin decks and stuff that existed back then that just don't exist now, because a lot of the cards are deprecated or a lot of the combos are too easy to break. I'd imagine there probably are still good goblin decks and elf decks and stuff. From what I understand, slivers have come back and are just as broken as ever. I thought slivers were great though, especially if you use a learn and recycle and you've just got all the slivers in your hand coming out for free. Only half the messages are being sent. Twitch is working on it. They're working hard on it. They don't like it any more than we do. So how do I actually combine them, because the documentation they gave me, it doesn't quite work. Can I concatenate with a plus equals, I wonder? Oops. So I can plus equals here then, can't I? Oh yeah, I mean, I think IRC caps at like 255 characters anyway, so I'm pretty sure there is a point where you'll type too much and you just overload it. Okay, so if that's the case, then what I want to show here is actually wave count. Dude, there's a lot of channels I get into and start talking about food, and then the entire rest of the time the stream is complaining about, oh, I'm so hungry now. It's actually rather funny. Odd. All right, let's see. No, it's fun to be a mug. Yeah, substring. Well, it definitely gets close. That's all good. Yep. 10-3. That's correct. 17-3. There we go, and it's a lot less spammy looking. It's a third of the operations it needs to do, which is good, because if I have 100 targets and it's gotta iterate through the list every time I kill one, then when I kill three in one shot, it won't hopefully kill the system entirely. Should be alright with that sort of stuff. Those are good, but those are only one unit at a time, and that's definitely not what I'm looking for here. Substrings are a good thing. Yeah, that's the point, Tannis. It needs to look through the entire list of all the targets to make sure that nothing of that wave exists anymore. So technically, the unit probably doesn't really matter as much, unless I want to have checks later on where the next wave deploys after half of the current wave has been eliminated instead of the entire wave. So its functionality I'm probably not going to need for a little bit, but I'm going to keep it there in case I want to use it later on. I just requested that song. That was up quickly. Nope, actually it isn't. I requested a different song. It just happened to play this right as I requested the other one from it. Dicks. Happens a lot. Thank you. The next thing is figuring out how I want to actually process all the wave numbers now that I can pull them. I don't necessarily need a list of lists so much as just something that checks if a specific wave is still active or not. Thanks, Nightbot. Is Landmark already patched? Fun to play with once I'm done with the work for today, though. Okay. Well then. Thank you. determining how I want to do it. If I want to use, I guess I do want to use a list. Maybe I want to kick it back to level manager, actually. Just have a separate list here. Damn, a lot of options for how to proceed here. I don't really need target movement up, do I? What the hell is this? Oh, yeah. Attach the target prefab, attach your level manager, and don't need target movement right now. In fact, I actually need to go take a break for a moment. I'll be back in just a few minutes. Thank you. I'm gonna write it down in the notepad while I'm thinking about it. Sorry, distractions here. It's all good. Thank you. Yeah, string, lowercase string rather. It's not target list. I wanted active waves. compared to the determined active waves. Well, I knew it was going to take a couple of days. Assuming that this is actually the best way to do this, like I said, there's a lot of ways that this could be done. And this one will probably end up having to be revisited and reviewed and redone at some point.
Thank you.
Hey, Daddy, how you doing? Welcome, welcome. Wave count equals wave. I'm working on getting the, this is day one of two of getting the, wave indicators, to work. So that way, when a wave is launched, all the targets are named properly. Now, I already had that, but now the next part is when all the targets in a wave have been destroyed, that wave needs to recognize that it's over and move on to the next wave, Right now I'm just doing a very simple method that if all of the previous waves have been eliminated, launch the next wave, or at least that's the initial goal. But then other versions can be messed around with a little bit later on. Count properly property of the list. Boy. So now let's do. Oh, right. Thank you. There can be units from multiple waves on the screen at the same time. I definitely want to be able to do that so I can have, like, different layers. Like, you've got three coming from the sides very slowly, and then right as those get towards the middle, a quicker line of them shoots through the middle, and then, you know, once those are about halfway through, some more shoot in from the diagonals, so that if someone really sits there and waits with their timing, they just fire one shot of each color in the middle and destroy them all. Something like that, something fun. Because I don't want to have more than, I don't want to have deployment done staggered for one wave. I don't want to have half a wave launch and then the next half of it launch 5 seconds later. That would, it'd be a new wave at that point. Cool, we can see that the wave is still active. Oops. Oops. Derpatastic. Okay, this will be good for now. I think I will wrap it up for today. Like I said, this is probably going to be a 2-day sort of thing. So, yeah, hopefully we'll be able to finish the functionality tomorrow. And then, if we have any more time tomorrow, start on the actual wave deployment functions. But if not, probably get going with those on the 18th, and then on the 19th hopefully be able to finish it up so I can actually have the semblance of a level, and then just put in some shots and some targets and some timing and play it out. So that should be fun, but that'll be over the next few sessions here. I am wrapping it up. Thank you very much, everybody, for coming through. This has been Unity Daily. I'm your host, Legendary Neurotoxin, and I will see you in, call it, 3.5 to 4 hours for live feature rant. So, have a good one, everybody.